Welcome back to Montana This Morning. The time is 6:47, looking like we have plenty of moving clouds overhead today, and it sounds like those clouds are holding some rain in there. So get those rain jackets and umbrellas ready, and if you have them, rain boots. That's one thing I wish I had for my toddler yesterday. Rain boots. She wanted to splash in the rain, but her little shoes got all soaked. All right, let's go ahead and jump right into news. We begin in Carbon County this morning, where a fatal crash is under investigation near the Wyoming border. It was reported around 4:30 Monday afternoon on Highway 310. Trooper Brody Shields says the rollover crash took the life of the driver, who was the only person inside the truck. What caused the accident and if any other vehicles were involved is still under investigation. A wood-burning stove is to blame for the blaze that broke out in Lame Deer this weekend, burning more than 1,700 acres. Northern Cheyenne Fire Management Officer Adam Wolf tells us the wood stove set a home on fire and the homeowner barely escaped through a window. Homes and structures were threatened, and it forced the closure of U.S. Highway 212 and Montana Highway 39. Wolf tells us it took a community effort to save the only store in town. Authorities have released the name of the man killed in a Billings Southside bar over the weekend. 24-year-old Shane Nez Purse died from multiple gunshot wounds. The shooting happened at Lee's Saloon on South 27th Street a little before 2 a.m. Saturday. Two other men in their 20s were also injured, but only one was taken to the hospital. No suspects are in custody. Police are investigating the incident as a homicide. A 17-year-old is lucky to be alive after he was attacked by a grizzly bear Sunday near Ennis. The teen was hiking south of Ennis near Wolf Creek when he says he heard a thump behind him. When he turned around, a bear was charging him. Although he was carrying bear spray, he couldn't use it before the bear was on top of him. At one point, the bear let go and the teen tried to escape, but he was knocked to the ground, face down and pinned again. But this time he was able to reach over his shoulder and spray the bear. Montana Fish, Wildlife and Park officials say that bear spray is likely the reason the teen was able to escape the attack with only minor injuries.
Things could have been much different for this boy. He's very lucky. He did a lot of things right. A big part of that is caring and knowing how to use bear spray. That's something we really encourage people to do. In addition to just being cautious, being aware of your surroundings and using caution.
Bear sightings are becoming more and more common as the weather warms up this spring. FWP warns that surprise encounters like this one could become more common as the bears begin their search for food after hibernation. Well, there's a new ruling when it comes to the presentation of tribal flags at high school sporting events. The Montana High School Association Board voted on Monday that the rules are outdated. Now Montana tribes can present their flags before the start of tournaments.
It's really important that the flags are honored along with the state flag and the U.S. flag, because we are an independent nation living within the state of Montana, but we work along with the state of Montana. I think that message came loud and clear that these flags need to be treated the same as the state flag.
This all comes after Poplar cheerleaders were told they couldn't present the Fort Peck tribal flag last month. The new policy will go into effect immediately. From the 66th session in Helena, the bill to let Northwestern Energy buy Colstrip Power is met with controversy. During its first hearing, dozens spoke for and against it. Northwestern Energy wants to buy Colstrip Power for $1. The bill says millions in costs can be charged to ratepayers with no Public Service Commission review. The company says they'll provide low-cost power to customers. Opponents say the company is trying to shift risk to customers.
In my opinion, is the Northwestern Energy School of Economics. Maximize your profits by socializing your risk. And while you're at it, turn the PSC into the regulatory dog wagged by the utility tail.
Now, Montana has made the mistake of continuously putting itself at the mercy of out-of-state entities that have little or no stake in this state. It's time that we learn from them mistakes and take steps to put more power over our energy future back into the hands of Montanans. And this will do it.
The House Energy Committee plans to vote on the bill Wednesday. The state Senate already approved the bill. A bill to help Montana firefighters who face on-the-job medical challenges has cleared another hurdle. Senate Bill 160 passed its final reading in the House Monday afternoon. The health and safety bill will provide coverage to firefighters who develop illnesses related to their job. This is the furthest the bill has made it during the firefighters' two-decade campaign. The bill will now head back to the Senate for approval before it lands on the governor's desk. An 81-year-old retired Great Falls priest appears in court to plead guilty to having child pornography. Lothar Krauth admitted to searching for images of child pornography and knew it was illegal. In October of 2018, the Department of Homeland Security and Great Falls Police seized 20 items of electronic media from his home. Krauth was assigned to Our Lady of Lourdes Catholic Church in Great Falls until 2014. His sentencing is set for July 18th. A Montana Republican is defending former Vice President Joe Biden, a 2020 presidential frontrunner, as he faces accusations of inappropriate touching. Jeannie Eckhart wrote an opinion piece on the issue, and it was published on Medium.com. Eckhart says her father was diagnosed with stage 4 brain cancer, the same as Biden's son, Beau. Eckhart was able to meet Biden during an event in Helena. She says they shared a long, big hug, and Biden was genuine and uplifting.
There's, of course, the big issue of consent, and it's, you know, of course, appropriate to ask for that and to kind of make yourself aware of that. But at least in my one situation, it was welcome, a hug, when I needed one. I never for a minute felt uncomfortable or that he was creepy. I think he would have hugged a young man in the same situation.
Eckhart worked for Republicans through her political career, including George W. Bush, Dick Cheney, and Sarah Palin. From the MSU campus, former U.S. Attorney General Jeff Sessions spoke to a sold-out crowd in Bozeman last night. He talked about freedom of speech and conservative ideas that he used during his decades in national politics, including his work with President Trump. He also brought up his support and the need for public support for our first responders, referencing Montana Trooper Wade Palmer, who was shot and severely injured in March. A key topic, freedom and the First Amendment. He also cited his upbringing in Alabama to reflect on a person's ability to find success anywhere.
I believe integrity, hard work, teamwork, the ability to show a certain amount of humility, to have lived with people of all different backgrounds, gives you some advantages that others don't have.
Sessions also visited Bozeman last June when he was still the acting U.S. Attorney General. Well, back here in Billings, a crowd gathered in the West High Auditorium Monday night to hear a Holocaust survivor share her story. As a child, Agnes Schwartz was raised under the constant threat of Nazi rule in Budapest. After her mother died at a Nazi concentration camp and her father was still at an unknown work camp, her Catholic nanny Julia took Agnes in and sheltered her in the basement of her apartment as the Allies were bombing Budapest. After the war, she was eventually reunited with her father and they moved to the U.S. Agnes travels the country sharing her message about the Holocaust.
That's what I'm hoping to do by telling young people, especially the young people, my life story, so that they'll take at least a couple sentences home with them and tell somebody that today they met a Holocaust survivor. And yes, it did happen. Don't ever let anybody tell you that it never happened. And unfortunately, my generation is dying out, and within the next few years, there won't be any live speakers anymore.
If you would like to learn more of her story, she has a memoir titled A Roll of the Dice. Governor Steve Bullock and First Lady Lisa Bullock kicked off Fight Childhood Hunger Week at the Capitol Monday. Nearly one in six Montana children will struggle with hunger. Organizers don't want people to feel ashamed if they need to ask for food. More than 40 events are planned across Montana as part of Fight Childhood Hunger Week.